Hey everybody, it's Monica with Scrapping for My Boys. So I'm here to show you a project that I did for Butterbee Scraps. What I have in front of me is pretty much everything that I used to create my canvas, aside from the metal. I used a lot of different pieces, so what I will go ahead and do is I will take a picture and insert it at the end of the video along with still shots of the canvas, of all of the filigrees that I use, so I don't take the time of going over every single item that I used. So very quickly, I used a 5x7 canvas from Michaels. These are relatively inexpensive. I always buy them when they're on sale for 4 for the price of 1. We have a spray sealer. I use my Adirondack Cranberry Color Wash. I use my Shimmers Paints Textures in the Gold Mine. I use just regular black acrylic paint. I use glossy accents, and I have my palette knife. I have my crystal katana that I use to adhere my bling down, and then we have the Spinabar Prima stencil in the background. I will say that my adhesive of choice when dealing with metal filigrees is glossy accents. A lot of people would go in and use E6000 when putting something on a canvas. I despise E6000. To me, for it being an industrial glue, it does not have industrial strength. I've been able to rip things apart and off of projects using E6000, and this is like weeks after it, you know, it's supposed to be dry. I've tried it days after and weeks after, and I've been able to pull things off, so I never use E6000. So let me get this stuff out of the way, and I will go ahead and show you the canvas. Alrighty, so this canvas I created for myself. It's gonna be one of many. It's gonna be going up on my wall. So here is my canvas. Every single metal piece that I used is in the shop. You can find all of it. There's nothing that's from my stash that is either discontinued or she doesn't carry. Everything on here is from the store. Now, this is heavy on metal. I know my projects tend to be on the heavy side when it comes to metal. I throw it around like nothing. I love it. I'm gonna put a whole bunch of stuff, you know, metal on my stuff. You might not like to use so much metal on your projects, but you can definitely put, you know, vary it in degree with how much metal you add. You could use paper flowers. I mean, the possibilities are endless on how you can create with metal. So for this, all I used was metal. I didn't use any paper piecings. I didn't use anything, no chipboard, nothing on here. So what I went ahead and did, I'll give you a brief summary of how I created it. I took my canvas and I sprayed my cranberry color wash all over it, front and back. I do finish the back. Then, and I will insert a picture as well as at the end. I shared it on my Instagram so you guys could see what it looked like. I showed a sneaky peek as I was using it. You have a marbleized background. You have darker areas and lighter areas from the color wash. So once my color wash dried, I went ahead and I stenciled it with the Prima stencil, and I used my Shimmers Paints Textures in the Gold Mine. And I went over the entire front as well as some portions on the sides. I didn't want to stencil the entire side. I only did little portions because it would take away. Now, the stenciling on the background will distract some people. I like it. My eye doesn't go towards the stenciling. When I look at this, my eye directly goes here to the middle. Other people, you know, the stenciling might be distracting to them. But this is for my room, so I went with it. I was originally gonna do just the metal on top of the cranberry background, but it looked very muted. It needed something else, so I chose the stenciling. Now, I did not seal the canvas when I did the color wash, so when I stenciled, some of that cranberry mixed into the texture paste. And mind you, this canvas had been dry. I heat set it, and I also let it sit out. It was sitting out probably for 30 minutes because my kids were hungry, so I went to make them breakfast. And it still bled through into my texture paste. If you don't want it to bleed into your texture paste, seal it once you do the color wash or your sprayed background before you add your stenciling to it. So I stenciled it once my texture paste was dry, I went in and I used my black paint. I just dipped my finger, nothing fancy, in my black paint, and I went all over the edges of my canvas on both sides. And I also did it to the back. And once I did that, once I didn't have as much paint on my hands, I also went over the stenciled areas to give them a little bit of a darker look so they weren't so bright. I mean, it still looks a little bright, but it got toned down quite a bit. Once all that was dry, I sealed the whole thing with my spray sealer. And that was before I adhered my metal to it. I sealed the front and I sealed the back. Once all of that was dry, I went ahead and I started adhering all of my metal to my canvas. Now, when you're working on the canvas, you have softer areas where you can push down. So if you're trying to push down your metal pieces as you're gluing down, sometimes you don't get that much of a stable area. So what I went ahead and did is I cut a piece of medium weight chipboard and I glued it to the back of the canvas. Now, you can cut it bigger. I just cut it to this opening here in the center. But you can cut it bigger and you can slide it in so the rest of the canvas has more support. I didn't really feel that was necessary because I only wanted support for the center area when I was gluing things down. So you can adhere chipboard to the back of your canvas so you have a firmer surface to work on when you're adhering things down. So I took this teardrop filigree, which is a new, part of the new release that she released last week. And I decided to create a large flower for the center. This is my focal point of my image. Then what I decided was I used the heart filigree, which is found in the shop. I used the medium copper gears, and I used some different styles. She has a mixed copper gear as well as bronze and silver, and then she has a mixed slot of all three together. You can find the copper gears in either pack. On this one, I just used the mixed copper gears pack. Then on top of all of the copper gears, I added the mini bronze gears to the centers. So we have five gears and five mini gears. Then after that, I adhered my corners. We have a large corner here, and this corner has like a bird type of shape engraved into the top, which I don't like. I love the corner, but I hate that engraved piecing. So I always use this Tibetan style corner on top of it. This is the same corner that I used on my scrapbook Me Layout, which is my previous DT project. So here we have a connector. You've seen this connector before. I used this on my decorative shadow box, my decorative shadow boxes, which was my first design team project. She carries these in two different sizes. I use the larger of the two, and I put one on each side and had them merge. Well, they connected. You can't really see it because I have the gear on top of it, and then I adhered the gear as the center, and I have that on both sides here. Once all of my metal was adhered, I went in with my spray sealer and I sealed it again. That way to protect it from any type of weather. Metal, the bronze metal, and I'm pretty sure the other ones might happen too, but I know for sure on the bronze, if it gets wet or if it gets moisture, it starts turning green. So I wanted to protect the metal, so I sprayed it again. And once I did I did two coats of the spray sealer on top of the metal. I sprayed the whole canvas all over again. Once that dried, and make sure that when you're doing a spray sealer, you do it outside or in a well-ventilated area because it is very stinky. So I sprayed it outside, and then once that was dried, I brought it inside and then I added bling to it because of course it can't be a Monica project if it doesn't have some kind of bling on it. So the bling I used is the amethyst bling. In the center of the corners, I put SS12 bling on it, as well as throughout the remainder of the canvas. Every single gear has an SS12 amethyst flat back rhinestone in the center. Then we also have two on each side of the gears. So we have one here, one right here, as well as here, and here. So that is it for my project. I absolutely love it. I got probably about six or seven more that I need to work on because this is going to go on a big piece on my wall as part of decoration. It's going to take me a while to get it done, so I will definitely be sharing my canvases as I go. So let's see, that is it. If you have any questions, please let me know. Once again, stay tuned at the end of the video. I will show pictures of all of the filigrees alone, except for this one, because this teardrop leaf, I use the entire package. It's a package of six, and all six are on my canvas. But I will share all of the other pieces that I used in a still shot, as well as still pictures of the canvas so you can get a close up in case the video didn't come out that well. Be sure to check out Butterbee Scraps on Twitter, Instagram, and Pinterest. She posts all of our projects on all the sites, as well as on Instagram and on Twitter. She'll go ahead and she announces when she has sales, promotions, giveaways, sneak peeks of new items when she's getting ready to release items, all kinds of stuff you will find on Twitter and Instagram. So go ahead and check her out. I believe her name on both of the sites is Butterbee Scraps. That's it. But I will go ahead and put them in the description box below as well. As well as I will link all of the items in the description box below. Each link takes you directly to that specific item that I used in case you want a particular item, it'll take you directly there. Alrighty, if you have any questions, leave a comment below. I always answer all of my comments. And I will see you in the next video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.